So we have with us Ms. Indrani S. Roy. Welcome to BW Business World. So my first question to you is, what are the major takeaways from the panel discussion that just now concluded?
I think quite an interesting one, because it touched upon how the nuance of leadership is changing in the current context of globalization and the generational workforce, especially in the context of India. So very interesting insights, speaking about authenticity, how technology is kind of shaping how organizations respond, skilling, reskilling. So a lot of topics which are very, very relevant right now were discussed. So some great takeaways from the discussion.
So post-COVID, we are seeing a lot, there's a term that is, being popularized, great resignation. So in the light of great resignation and evolving workforce expectations, how can leadership redefine employees' experience?
I think great resignation was something which happened a year and a half back, and I think the world is again moving to stability. I think great resignation was triggered by this whole need for survival and need for doing what, grabbing an opportunity in life and doing what really resonated with you. I think we're baselining again. But as leaders, I think resignations are triggered by two things. If you cannot fulfill the purpose and the passion that an individual has, and you cannot show that direction to the individual, then the individual feels quite disillusioned. The second thing is, how are you creating a culture around the person? And the manager or the leader plays a key role. So I think the imperative for us is now to build a purposeful organization where every individual understands how they're contributing to the organization's strategic priorities. And two, which is very important for me, is how are we creating an ecosystem or the managerial ecosystem for an individual where he or she feels safe and completely himself or herself to express and be, be nurtured. So the role of a manager, because as you know, the biggest reason a single employee stays or leaves an organization is because of the manager. So I think that understanding and that relevance of providing impetus there is very, very important.
So you talked about stability in the career. So there are a lot of employees who are facing mental health issues. So how are you addressing these concerns at your organization?
So firstly, accept that the demographics of workforce is changing, and well-being, which uses the nuance, and I spoke about it, about mental health is real. First, an acceptance that it is a real issue, and the issue emanates not from an individual, but the kind of access to information, the complete overload. Think about myself as a generation. I was quite secluded from the data overload that I have, information overload that I have. And today's generation, they've grown up in a digital age with mobile phones since birth, access to information, now generative AI, so much with them. So for them to find peace and purpose and stick to that is very important. So how we're responding is, of course, the ecosystem of providing the right cultural context, the right help through counselors. But more than that, just creating a workplace where you feel safe and bring your own self to work. Because if you can come and express to me saying, Irani, I feel burnout. I think it's a job well done of an organization, because I've allowed you, Abhishek, to come and tell me I feel burnout and I'm seeking help. So we are trying to create a culture where we allow people to be their own selves and not be in a fear of expressing themselves and seek help. I think if we just manage these, we will be able to create an ecosystem where we can really help our employees and our colleagues go through the whole rigmarole of well-being in a more broader sense.
So in India, mental health issues are considered as a taboo topic. We don't talk about much about it. So how much time India will need to, when an employee can go to his or her manager and talk about mental health issues very openly?
I think that's about inclusion, which is what I told you. I think we are a couple of years away from creating a very, very safe space. Where managers don't have biases. So it's not about organizations. I go back to managers and our unconscious biases and stereotypes. We don't want to accept that there is a work-life fit issue. We judge people through our experiences. So first, the traditional seniors and leaders in the organization need to unlearn and look at their own children and grandchildren to see how they... So try and personalize. If you personalize and see in your immediate vicinity, in your family, that it's real. And then try to recognize that that reality is also extending to your organization. I think we will make a faster progress. If we leave it to HR policies and processes, we are a long way off. Yeah.
So, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you, Abhishek. Pleasure. Thank you.